Dear students, welcome to all of you. Today I am taking class on nutrients of food, digestion and absorption. This is from chapter 8, class 7, home science. So first of all, nutrients. What is called nutrients? Nutrients are the biochemical components which present in foods and that provide nutrition to our body. Do you know what do you mean by biochemical components? Biochemical means the chemical substances that basically present in living organisms. Okay, so these are the nutrients. As you all know, there are different types of nutrients in food which gives us nutrition. Let's have a look at the types of nutrients. There are six nutrients: protein, carbohydrate, fat, vitamins, minerals and water. These are the six nutrients. These are the major nutrients, five major nutrients with water. Okay, now the first nutrients, let's discuss protein. Protein is the chief nutrients of all living beings and it consists of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. You see in this chemical structure of protein, here you see C for carbon, H for hydrogen and O for, very good, oxygen. And you see that N represents nitrogen. Only protein has nitrogen. Okay. And if the protein is broken down into small parts, we get amino acids. Basically, after digestion, we get protein from, we get amino acids. And after breakdown of protein, we get amino acids, and which is absorbed through our small intestine and transported to the blood. So it is the end product of protein. So these amino acids actually joined together to create a protein molecule. You see, this is the primary structure of protein molecule, which consists of amino acids. Now the classification. Here the classification basically based on the sources of protein. We get protein from animal source and we also get protein from vegetable source. Okay, so animal source, but animal protein consists meat, fish, egg, milk. These are the high quality protein because these nutrients has essential amino acids. Okay, and vegetable protein consists pulses, nuts, soybeans, rice. These are also important. The people who are very poor, they cannot afford high quality protein, they also meet their needs by taking this vegetable protein. Okay, now these are the picture of protein from animal source and protein from vegetable sources. Okay, you see, you have the chicken piece, leg piece, I think you like it, right? Okay, now say that you have to take at least 20 to 25% of protein from your daily 20 to 25% of calorie from your daily diet. Okay, so this is the sections of protein. So now we will go to the functions of protein, which is very most important. I think you should learn carefully. The most important functions of protein is to build body and helps to grow. That means this is the major functions of protein. For example, you see this is a brick, and brick is important for building a house, right? So protein is act like a brick to build our body. And this is again another picture of the growth of a sapling. You see how the sapling was too small, and then finally gradually become taller. People also gradually become taller because of protein. So protein helps to grow also. So this is the major or main functions of protein. Please keep it in your mind. Second major important functions of protein is it protects us from decay. As you know that if after some time the cells become damaged and there are new cells reformed, and in here we see that protein fulfill the laws of the body and builds new cell. So you see that protein plays a role to heal a wound also. Okay, let's see. This is a practical example. I don't actually encourage you to make a nail, bigger nail, but this is for example. You see that after cutting your nail, after some days it will grow bigger, right? This is basically the growth of happening because of protein, right? So this is one of the example, good example. You can also see that when we cut our hair, after some days the hair also grows. Why? Because of the protein. Okay, so these are the very good and visible example of how protein reform new cells. Another important thing is that protein heals a wound. After I can give you a scary picture, but don't get scared. This is a this picture. You see that after sometimes the wound is healed. That means this is also the functions of protein. Okay. There is a small information regarding protein, that is when we burn 1 gram protein we can get 4 kilocalories. That means protein has the capabilities to produce energy. So if we burn 1 gram fat we can get 4 kilocalories. So now let's go to do a math. Okay, are you ready? Okay, so here is the math. If a piece of meat contains 50 gram of protein, how many kilocalories we get? Now tell me, as this is, I already gave you the formula that 1 gram protein has 4 kilocalories. So 50 gram protein equals to how many calories? 1, 2, 3. Yes, 100 calories. Okay, now the fourth function. I think you already recognize this virus. Basically, when any virus go inside our body, if our immune system produce antibody. So when the antibody has more power, they can easily bind the virus and destroy the activity of the viruses. And by this way, the people become healthy, or the people recover from sickness. Okay, so in this antibody basically formed, and protein helps to develop antibody, right? So this, you see that protein has a very important and major functions of developing antibody. Okay, so number 5, protein helps to develop our brain. You know that brain is the most important system, or important, it's like our major traffic signal system. All the signals, all the activities goes to the brain, and there are so many nerves which basically give the signal to the different organs to active, to become to work according to the signal. So here you see that the development of brain also depends on protein. Protein needs to develop our brain. So these are the five major functions of protein. Protein is indispensable for the development of our brain. So if we summarize, you can see that protein has many functions in different organs, different parts of our body. Like I already told you earlier that hair and nails, these examples of growth and examples of growth are built, muscles, antibodies, formation of blood, brain and nerves, and also enzymes. These are all the major functions provided by protein. Okay, now the results of protein deficiency in a body. Okay, then there are different types of deficiency symptoms happening due to deficiency of protein. These are the minor symptoms like muscle weakness, poor health, hair health, weak and brittle nails, poor sleep, irregular menstrual cycle, brain fog. These are the minor protein deficiency. So due to protein deficiency, our normal growth obstructed. As you know that the major functions is to become, is the growth of the body, so that obstructed. Long-term deficiency leads to kwashiorkor. Kwashiorkor, I will show you in the next slide what is kwashiorkor actually. Immunity power decreases due to deficiency of protein and decreases of memory also. So you can also be careful about intake of your protein meal, right? Now, kwashiorkor thing, this is the picture of kwashiorkor disease. This baby has swollen belly, that means there are so many water accumulated in the belly. And they are very much serious lack of protein, and this is the result of protein deficiency. Okay, all about protein. So I hope you already know what is protein and how many kilocalories we get from 1 gram of protein. This is also a very easy question. I think you all know. Now I want to give you our homework. That is, protein is very important for our health. Explain why. Please write it in your homework copy.